Hello, ATR 102ers. My name is Dr. Cosby. Welcome to the Canvas page for your online course, which is Risk Management and Emergency Response. This is really a two-part course. You have the online portion and the lab portion. Please note that the lab portion has its own Canvas page, so you will need to go there to see when we're meeting for lab and what we're doing in lab for the respective weeks. With that being said, I realize that a lot of you in this class are first-time freshmen and may have never taken an online course before, so I kind of wanted to navigate you through the learning management system that we use, which is Canvas. So this is your home page. Anytime you log into Canvas, this is the first page that will come up. From this page, you can do a few things. You can email me directly from this page, you can access the course syllabus, or you can access the course modules as well. With that being said, majority of the time you're going to spend in the course modules, and about 10% of the time you'll spend in the syllabus page. So because the syllabus is a contract between the student and the faculty member, I wanted to start with the course syllabus. Course syllabus is going to tell you what my expectations are of you. So number one, because this is an online course, we never meet. We only meet in Canvas, in the virtual world. That being said, our lab class will meet in kinesiology classroom number four, more to be described in the lab course itself. Also have the course aim, and most importantly, the student learning outcomes, which is really what I expect you guys to either be able to do, to demonstrate. It's your body of knowledge that you should have by the time you leave my course. And if you don't have it, then I didn't do a really good job explaining it or preparing you for it. There's also a required textbook, and yes, this is a required textbook that the student must buy. And it becomes important because it helps you be successful on the quizzes that you'll take on a weekly basis. So yes, there are online lectures, and unfortunately, I just can't get through all of the content in specific chapters because they're too long and I would bore you during the online lecture. So this is required. It is currently housed in our bookstore. However, you can also purchase it online, I think through Amazon. So either option, just be prepared to have the textbook when you're going through the course modules. One of the biggest things I think in terms of making an online course very successful is how much the students interact with each other in the virtual world. So a lot of your grade is really, truly, honestly, kind of built on or based on the fact that you're interacting and you're posting and you're interacting again with your peers in this particular class. How will you be spending the majority of your time in this class? Well, about 13 hours in the semester, you'll be spending reading and listening to online lectures. And you can see the second highest number of hours that you'll spend would be really participating with the information and your peers in an online kind of setting. So it becomes very important for you to get used to checking in and logging into Canvas and checking your modules and your discussion boards. What I kind of say to students in an online class is it's really like a text message, right? You have this text message and you guys are going back and forth and you're texting, you're almost communicating via text. Well, discussion boards are very similar, right? In that if you post a response, you should check it every hour or so just to make sure to see if anyone else has responded. And if they respond, then you're supposed to respond back to them. So it almost becomes this ping pong match. So how will you be assessed or how will you be graded? Big portion of the class will be discussion boards where you will be asked to interact and then respond to other peers' responses. Another large component are the projects and the homework assignments that are going to be due, which I think leads me to one of my biggest points in the class is that I do not accept late work. Unfortunately, in an online class, when you are late with an assignment, it is almost impossible for your peers to interact with that material or that content. So unfortunately, I do not accept late assignments. I make these assignments due at 11:59 p.m. the day that they are due. So that gives you the entire day to complete this assignment or this task. The only time I've ever accepted a late assignment is if there's a family or medical emergency, at which case then the student just presents some type of documentation to me and I'll accept that assignment. So notice the warning, I do not accept late assignments, so please don't turn in assignments late, please don't interact on the discussion boards late, and your grade won't be penalized for that. That being said, I keep saying modules. The course modules is where you'll spend 90% of your time, so we're going to click on that modules tab on the left-hand side of your Canvas course page, and what you will now see are all of your course modules with all of the content. If I were you, I would always start in the order in which things are listed. So start with navigating the Canvas course. Your first assignment and discussion board will be this Introduce Yourself, which is due August 31st at 11:59 p.m. Then you have a list, if you click here, a list of all of the readings that you might need or lectures to be successful in your first chapter one quiz. So I hope that makes sense in terms of how things are laid out. We go back to the modules and we're looking at module number one. You will see that there's always going to be a quiz, and the quiz is usually indicated by like an airplane kind of figure. And then any course content pages typically look like a scroll pad, any discussion board type assignment kind of looks like a text message or two. So you can kind of get used to the layout. Notice that I really don't say when you should finish the module, but you should notice that the module assignment is due on September 14th. So you have from now until September 14th to get through all the content. And then obviously there are quizzes and discussion boards along the way. And that flow kind of goes throughout the entire course. You have a midterm, which will be due, and it's marked somewhere within the actual Canvas course. So the midterm is here. And then the last thing that you have is a final exam. You have both a multiple choice and you have a final written exam that are due on December 15th. With that being said, some people finish the class early. An online course is really designated to go at your own pace within reason. So with that being said, I've had people finish in October because they just want to finish the course. That is completely up to you on how fast you do it. In terms of slow, I've created due dates, so you can't be too slow because you have to turn things in so I know that you're getting through the content on time. So I'm very excited about online courses. I know a lot of times when students hear, oh, it's an online course, it's going to be boring. My hope is that I've really made this interactive, that I can interact with you guys to encourage you guys to get in on those discussion boards. So please, 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 please be very active in this online course. As always, if you should have questions, feel free to email me, but I've also in the syllabus page put my cell phone number because I've had students who have something's not working, their cell phone can't take video or whatever it might be. So you can always send me a text message on my cell phone. And most of the time I respond if it's before 10 o'clock. With that being said, I'm excited. I hope you enjoy interacting in this online course. Thank you so much for listening to this.